up close and personal on the streets of Boston.
I ended up dying, like, you're not going to die.
Was there a major artery or anything?
We don't know. You were shot in the groin, but we don't know where the bullet is.
I think it's right there, way up in your thigh.
Look at her wrist. Her wrist broke.
Tell her to hold her arm. We're going down Francis Street.
They need to fix these damn streets.
Ambulance 13, Boston.
A minute from now, I could be in the middle of complete chaos.
Get out of here, dude.
Hey!
Two patients, one's critical.
Oh my God.
Get sliced in his belly.
Speed is a factor.
You gotta move, lady. You gotta move.
We're actually urban warriors. It's just, it's Boston. That's what we do.
Ambulance 6, Boston, 86. Report of a person shot. Dorchester Ave at Dexter Street in South Boston.
Police are calling that they have a guy shot. C8 Admiral Dodd Ave in Dexter. You know, you think about scene safety, but this sounds like there's plenty of police there. And mostly with shootings, you know, you think about blood loss. Gentleman, he was laid out on the sidewalk with the police officer there. He was shot way up in his upper thigh.
Which side are you shot?
That's all right here. Oh.
It looked to me like the gunshot happened at relatively close range because there was actually a powder burn around the wound.
You're not losing a lot of blood right now. We're going to put you right in the ambulance.
Mother. All right, okay, don't do all that.
I ended up dying, like, this is in my leg. Like,
you're not going to die.
Dying my leg.
Just get the bed.
Ignore any patient that says they're going to die because they might know something you don't.
He's shot in his upper thigh. It's like up underneath his scrotum, really.
Come on, you got to let the bag go. Let the bag go. Let the bag go. On our end, the guy's awake. He's alert. He's not sweaty. He's not pale. But he has the potential to deteriorate. Because you can lose a large amount of blood into your thigh. So we don't want to waste any time.
Where it is? There's no way it works.
It's definitely in your leg.
Is it in a major artery or anything?
We don't know.
It's way up in your thigh. I think it's right there.
Injury, possible MVA, Old Colony at Columbia Road, at 31810.
We're going to a busy rotary for a female who's lying in the rotary. Question of airbags deployed in the vehicle, facial injuries. It's not very specific. It definitely has potential to be bad.
Yeah, let's get you in the ambulance, okay? Does anything hurt?
My eyes.
Your eyes?
Yeah.
Did the airbag go off in your face?
I just see sparks.
Come over here and have a seat.
Yeah, it looks like it caught fire.
I just don't know if she burned her eyeballs.
Sounds like she's complaining of facial injury. Her eyes, the airbag on the driver's side caught fire, and you can actually see the plastic is singed. There's not a lot of damage to the front end of the car. The wheels, axles are intact. There's no bumper damage, so that's good. Are you okay, sir? You were the passenger of this vehicle?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you need to get checked out? Is anything hurt right now?
No, I'm fine, man.
You sure?
I'm just freezing.
If you look at the steering wheel, right where the airbag deploys from, the airbag came out and it does look like it caught fire. Yeah, it's all burnt, the plastic's all melted, so.
She got some very severe burns to her sclera, which is the white portion of your eyes. You really couldn't even see the pupil of her eyes because it was so blistered over.
It's just a cold cloth that I'm going to put on your eyes.
So that, like, applied some sterile dressings with some sterile saline water to help with the pain.
I try not to.
Can I do that?
Yeah.
Thank you.
There you go. You put the pressure on it, okay?
It's kind of helping.
Is it good?
Yeah.
All right. So I'm going to sit you back up a little bit. Get more comfortable?
Yeah.
All right. There we go.
Thank you.
Can you see at all?
Well, when I got out of the car, I opened my eyes and everything was just blurry, but the skin on my eyelids do feel burned.
Doing all right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I thought she was blind instantly. That was like my main concern. Yeah, definitely. Because I seen everything else on it was all right, and I wanted to lose her eyesight, you know? It's a very serious thing.
All right, darling, we're here. Okay?
I'm gonna pull you out of the ambulance, okay?
Yeah.
She's 20 years old. It's a serious injury. Good. We hope there won't be any permanent damage to her sight.
It's definitely in your leg.
Is it in a major artery or anything?
We don't know. We're shot in the groin, but we don't know where the bullet is.
Person shot, who shot in the right side of his groin at close range.
Were you trying to tuck a gun in your pants? You sure?
Was it?
All right. There was no hole in his outermost layer of clothing, so if somebody else shot him...
No exit wound.
He would have had to have had a hole in his pants, which there wasn't.
It's all police calling.
How you doing? You shoot yourself?
I'm sitting on the stairs and someone come out and poisoned
it. Really?
Yeah.
All right, take care of you. Sure you didn't do this?
I didn't do it.
All right. Gonna go to the hospital right now. I was a little forward with my questioning. I didn't really beat around the bush. Many times in our experience that we have someone that shot right there in that spot, it's sometimes self-inflicted. By accident.
I shot in the chest before. I'm not
sure
worried about
chest?
This. Yeah. 1994.
This third movie.
Oh, my God. I keep trying to get there.
You see, thank you, Buster. Relax. Relax.
It's like if I survive, it's like...
You'll survive it. Don't worry about it.
I can't change my life. This is crazy.
Yep.
I just had a baby. Like, I can't do this.
You're going to see a baby. How old's your baby?
12 months.
All right. He's a real baby. There you go. He was very lucky to have had a gunshot wound right there and miss any big vessels. He could have lost his life. There's going to be a couple of bumps coming out, all right? Don't figure it out. We did jump the gun about maybe how we thought it happened. He denied it. That's okay. We're not judging him. He's a patient first. So it's our job to let him know that he's going to be home to his family and his 9-month-old. I think he's going to be fine.
Some biker slipped on ice and can't move. Hurt his hip. No head strike, no LOC.
I ain't doing it for my health.
Is he inside the operator? We can't get in the operator. The gate's closed. We used to have keys to every gate in the city and every truck. I don't know what happened. I don't know if somebody did something to get him taken. Remember that, Bo?
They're gone now.
Yeah.
We don't have them anymore.
Hey, Bo.
Yo.
You want to get out and check him?
Yeah, I slipped on the ice on my bike. I landed right on my hip. I can't move my leg.
Okay.
Let me know what it hurts. Right over here, brother?
No, more on top. Like right
here?
Yeah, like right there. Oh,
okay.
Yep.
All right. So we're going to get the stretcher and get you out of here and get you in the warm. Hey, Chiz, left side of hip pain. Other than that, no C-spine tenderness or nothing like that. Make sure it's not a fractured pelvis or anything like that. So one of the major concerns, if you do have a pelvic fracture, you can actually bleed a good volume of your blood supply, like almost like 2/3 of your blood supply, into the pelvic area. It's almost like a cavity like that.
No matter what we do right now, it's going to hurt. So we're going to just lift you up and get you out of the cold, okay?
Jesus.
Got to get you on the side. Ready?
Okay, let's go. Right. Let's do it. Do it. Come on.
Ready?
Go. Go. Oh, thank you. Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. We got it.
Get you inside.
You know, this is the time of the year when you need to put the bikes up. Black ice, that type of stuff. Roughly, in my opinion, put up the bike, take the tea, carpool, whatever, so.
I work at an elementary school in Brookline, in Coolidge Corner.
You want to bike all the way out to Coolidge Corner, huh?
Yeah.
Impressive.
It's not too bad when, you know, slip and bust your hip.
He's pretty much stable other than the pain there. But I did feel some swelling there, like maybe more muscular than anything else. But we'll see, you know. But I'm comfortable that he's a stable patient under the circumstances. One of the big things is some pain management meds, right?
Yeah, bring it on.
That's what I need. I think the guy's gonna actually fare off fine. All in all, another lightsaber, you know. And on to the next, right?
Next on Boston EMS.
A lot of smoke. This fight is going really good.
Oh, right here when it first started.
Okay.
Hey, right.
EMT for the state for between 6 and 7 years now. I got into being an EMT because I like to help people. It's, you know, fun being out here, meeting different people every day.
We got a little zoo here going.
It's fun. I've always liked anatomy, physiology, learning about medicine. I'm 25 years old, and I just proposed to my girlfriend, and now I'm saving for the wedding, so I'm working a little bit of overtime. Some people might think that 25 is an early age to get married. I mean, I had my fun, and I met somebody I really love, so it's the perfect time. I mean, I have a great job.
We're going to help you up, okay? We don't want to keep you here on the cold sidewalk.
A beautiful fiance, and hopefully we'll be starting the next chapter of our life soon, getting a house, having a couple kids.
Oh, I'm hitting a wall.
So the timing's great for me. Everything's working out. So we just got a call. A mother is calling for her 9-year-old son who has a hand laceration, and it says it's from glass. I'm sure the 9-year-old's going to be pretty upset. This is probably a pretty big emergency to him. So.
Hop right in there. It's cold out.
Come right over here for me.
So when we got on scene, we found mom outside with her two boys. So what happened?
Fell on a piece of glass?
Okay. Okay, we're just going to clean it up a little bit, okay? You're being very brave. I know this is probably pretty painful, okay? So we got a little laceration here on the side of the thumb, so it wouldn't be a bad idea to get it checked out.
But yeah, it's not going to hurt.
Listen, they got this really cool glue that they can use.
Yeah.
You don't have to put no
just
needle.
Like glue that you would use like doing any arts and crafts, they can do the same. Kids are really afraid of stitches, and they think that it's going to be this big, painful procedure. So he was just kind of scared, but we were able to comfort him and tell him that there are some other options.
It's hard being a kid.
I know, yeah. Being an adult's no fun, huh?
All right. Well, let's go get it fixed.
You got school in the morning?
I bet you they give you the day off from school to let your hand heal up a little bit.
You got a few boys, so I'm sure you...
Five sons.
Yeah. Wow.
So this is a basic ordinary day for me.
7 kids. She's got 5 boys. I only have 1 sibling personally, and I know that was crazy enough, so I can't imagine growing up with 6, 7 other siblings.
See? We're here.
They're picking it up.
No,
we're going to bring you in there.
Yay!
Boys will be boys, what can I say? I just have to take it by a grain of salt.
Get your hands full.
Oh, yeah.
Mom wasn't phased at all. Boys are going to be boys, and accidents are going to happen. And I think she was pretty comfortable with the fact that it's not going to be the last time.
Be careful. Please, no more accidents. I don't need it. Not today.
Yo. Should we bring you in, too? All right.
They're only 8 years old, so imagine what they're going to be doing when they're 16, 17, you know?
Responding out to Brighton. It's a confirmed fire. There's no reports of any injuries, but we always respond to fires. You know, once the firefighters start working, there's a big potential for a firefighter to get injured.
Attention, engine 50. Cover station 33.
All right. And obviously, if there's any, you know, civilian victims of the fire, we want to be there and be ready. smoke. I mean, this fire is going really good. Yeah, there's no patience yet, but we got still heavy fire through the roof.
Everybody's out. This house right here.
Everybody's out.
Right.
Everybody's out of all the house. Oh, not here when it first started.
Okay.
Right. Some animals. All right. We came up here. We saw the smoke billowing out. Of course, at that point there, we put it on the radio, and then I went out, and we kind of were evacuated some people. Anybody who was in there was out. We made sure of that.
Our dog got out with us, which is awesome. We noticed that more sparks were going by our bedroom window, so we looked outside and noticed that the top porch was on fire. First, we ran upstairs to see what was going on, and we asked them, you know, did you call the 911 yet? They said no, so I called 911, and we evacuated the house. It's really shocking. You have everything 1 second, and then 2 minutes later, everything is gone.
How's it going?
You guys got any injuries?
No.
Good.
Nothing. We're doing good so far.
It was roaring.
I know. I got here. There was a fireball coming through the roof. I was like, oh, boy. Just to try to appreciate how stubborn a fire can be. All these fire trucks, the amount of water that's been poured on that house, and you'll still see little bits of fire coming through the roof. It's just, it's always amazed me. Boston CA. I'm going to release paramedic 16. I'm going to keep ambulance 14 here for a bit longer. We're very lucky. I mean, this was a very big fire in a densely populated residential neighborhood. We got out of this without any injuries to occupants and no injuries to any of the firefighters. So we're very fortunate here tonight.
Next on Boston EMS.
Look at her wrist. Her wrist broke.
Let me take it to the hospital, please.
And now we're responding to a 55-year-old lady had a fall. She has some kind of fracture.
Her daughter called. Her daughter said it might be an arm fracture.
If this is an arm fracture, what we'll do is we'll stabilize her arm. We'll splint it into place. And if we get it into a position of comfort for her, then that's better off.
Look at her wrist. Her wrist broke.
No, I see it.
Yeah. Okay.
Can we sit up?
No, you
got to
be careful because you're on black ice yourself.
Watch yourself,
see?
Because it's cold on the floor. Let's start with getting you up off the floor.
Black ice. Oh, my God.
It's going to hurt.
I just opened my door to come out to go to work, and I heard her yell. So I just ran over, and her daughter was coming out at the same time.
Ready? One, two.
That's my mother. She was on her way to an appointment at Beth Israel, and she slipped on the black ice that's still currently in the parking lot.
She lived in that development. It was assaulted. She came out of house to go to a doctor's appointment and fell and broke her wrist.
Can I straighten it?
Wait a minute.
Okay.
No, no,
okay.
No, no.
Okay. Once they age, your bones become a little more brittle, so I'm sure she's in immense pain.
It hurts.
Can you kind of rest your hand on that right there, kind of?
I'll try.
Technically, we're supposed to splint that injury, sling it, but if it's making her uncomfortable, I'm not going to tie her arm down to her body. Think it'll feel more comfortable against your body?
I just hold it like this.
Okay. I know it's painful. You'll be getting some pain meds right away.
God, let me make it to the hospital, please.
Cassine.
Yeah?
Tell her to hold her arm. We're going down Francis Street.
Ow. Oh, God, they need to fix these damn streets.
I got to feel to see if I can feel it.
How can you feel a pulse?
It looks ugly, but I can feel a good, strong pulse there, so that's good.
I just want it fixed. That's all that goes through my mind.
I feel bad for that lady. She's probably going to need surgery. She's going to be in the hospital for a long time. She's a tough lady. She'll be all right. What a damn shame. Elderly people can't even walk down the damn street.
That's a damn shame.
Excuse me, sir. My partner today is Walter Dunbar. Walter is an avid runner, and he is planning to run. Walter, are you running 40 miles? Is that how far you're running?
40 miles, the WD-40 on my 40th birthday.
If only my fat, disgusting patootie could run that far, I would most certainly do that.
MVA with injuries in Dorchester,
458-12. Sounds like a pretty minor MVA. Someone kind of just clipped her back bumper and pulled it off and then kept driving.
He hit and run, pretty minimal, seatbelt, total consciousness.
There it is.
And I can tell you for sure that if you're in pain now, you'll be in even more pain later.
Only problem, I really can't leave my car there. My boyfriend don't have a license.
You can do one of two things, if that's the biggest concern.
No, my biggest concern is finding out who did this, because they're the ones who's going to have to be responsible for my car factor and everything. I have serious back problems already.
Okay, well, right now, the medical stuff is what we're concerned about. Like, the police will do their job on that. There's tons of cameras around here and stuff.
We just recommend getting you checked out so we can make sure that this problem doesn't get bigger than what it already is.
I can't. I have a business. I was from a business. I'm a cleaner. I have to call people, cancel them. I have a lot of work to do, and I can't do that at the hospital.
If you don't want to go to the hospital with us, okay, we'll just have you sign a refusal. There's no bill. We didn't transport you.
She felt more comfortable with driving back to her home, getting her stuff, taking care of her business, and then going back to the hospital on her own.
It's overwhelming when you know there's a lot of people counting on you.
It is.
That you always, you know, I have to take care of business.
Accidents are never convenient. Yeah. It's always the worst time. Yeah. Just take it real easy, okay?
Okay.
All right, good luck, yeah, okay? She's a nice girl. Tough day. Accidents suck.
A3 responded for the injury priority to number 17, a burn place in Roxbury.
We're responding to a call for carbon monoxide at a school. You want to pay attention to anything that could turn into a mass casualty incident. I mean, carbon monoxide will displace the oxygen from your red blood cells. A high enough CO level will kill you. We'll check in with the fire department and see what's going on.
Reading of 160 inside, they think it's the furnace, was readings were the highest at the vents, which are up at the ceiling.
Yeah.
The ladies that were in there, they were actually in the gym doing a dance program. That's where the alarms are going off. We're in the gym.
All right.
0 to 3 is not considered detrimental, and anything from 3 up would be a concern. We're just waiting for it to pull up. Any dizziness, nauseousness?
I didn't feel anything. It was just hard for me to breathe while I was in there.
Okay. And how long were you in there for?
An hour.
We were dancing, so I did a lot of breathing.
We were having dance practice,
and it started to smell like gas, and we got out of there. The fire department came, and here we are.
I felt burning sensations in my eyes. I felt very clogged in my throat, coughing a lot, and dizziness.
Okay, we're currently going to be evaluating 7 patients, unsure on transports as of yet.
Right now she's reading 0, which is very good.
We're using a device that gives us the level of carbon monoxide that could be in their blood. And if somebody comes up really high, you know, we'll put them on 100% oxygen to help flush that carbon monoxide out of their system.
More important than any number that we can come up with on a device is how you feel. If you feel sick, then we should take you down to the hospital. All the machinery and stuff is great, but it comes down to how you feel. You don't want to go down to the hospital with us, is that what you're saying? You want to go home?
Okay.
All right. How I feel.
Yeah, that's totally fine.
Okay. All right, these ladies are just going to get some information from you and have you sign something, and it's fine. She's going to refuse, so there's not going to be any transports.
The bottom line is right now you're not going to be able to go back in the building, so I guess the dance class is over for tonight.
So in the end, everybody declined going to the hospital. Their symptoms, for the most part, had subsided between the fresh air and the oxygen. So I think, you know, all's well that ends well.
next on Boston EMS.
When you see someone that's that in pain, it's obvious. I mean, you feel bad. You know, you want to be able to do something.
We're going to a 22-year-old man whose wife called and said that he is having abdominal pain. He has no other symptoms.
And we get there. He's ambulatory, you know. He looks like he's in pain. He said it started suddenly about 10, 15 minutes ago, and it was up in his left upper quadrant.
Can you go to Brigham and Women's?
Yeah, that's fine.
Because his mom works there as well, just in case something happens.
Oh, most definitely, most definitely. Yeah. And just 10 minutes ago, it just started causing pain like that? All right. When you point, that's where your spleen is. To me, it seems like it's his spleen. That can be very painful. It seemed like the pain was, it was intermittent. It would come, it would go, it would be 10 out of 10. It would be 4 out of 10.
Up to him, I thought I heard him crying, and he was damn near on the floor, like crunching on his knees.
It feels like I'm getting stabbed over and over,
yeah.
And I can't do nothing about it.
He doesn't go to get regular checkups, so you can never, I never know what could happen.
Most men don't go to doctor,
but y'all gotta get it together because
you know what we usually do, we just wait till something's wrong.
No,
we don't do preventative maintenance. Gotta get a checkup. I just started getting checkups. I work in this field for 18, 20 years.
I'm in school for nursing, so I always tell people, like, I promote good health, but I don't always follow it. We've been married for a year and 4 months. We supported the family at the moment while I go to school, and then we're gonna switch.
You don't find too many young people that do that nowadays.
We're trying. Especially my wife. That's why I bust my ass at work to make sure that she, you know, she don't need for nothing. Our kids don't need for nothing.
I couldn't believe that. She was like, we're married, been married for a year now. They got 3 kids. She's going to school. He's supporting her, working little jobs. And then when she finishes, gets her nursing degree, he's going to go back to school. That was amazing. Good for you. Anybody want to be in the street or be a rapper?
Watch your elbow on this. Watch your elbow.
When I was that age, I wasn't thinking like that, you know, fresh out of college. I mean, I had kids too, but I wasn't thinking like they were thinking. They were thinking, they planning ahead. They have very good heads on the show. Very good, very good.
I've been an EMT for 2.5 years. After high school, I had no idea what I wanted to do. I went to hairdressing school. I did that for a little while, didn't really like it. I thought about becoming a nurse, but I didn't want to go to college for so many years, and I'm like, oh, I'll become an EMT, and you know, I'll see how I like it, and I just fell in love with it. It's fun, it's exciting.
Kick your legs up there and just lay back, okay?
No, go, my mom.
To be good at this job, I think you need to have patience, some compassion, sometimes just be there to listen and let people vent.
Never had a place on my own.
Sorry to hear that. Hopefully never. Soon.
The best job I've ever had.
Ambulance 10 Boston. 10, can you start for an illness 3?
Ambulance 68, more time at BMC.
So we're going for
a 50-year-old male with nausea, vomiting, and abdominal pain. Sean, did I take you, like, 2 weeks ago?
Was it 2 weeks ago?
I think so. Maybe a little bit longer.
Colitis came back.
Oh, man.
No problem, sir. She's been vomiting for about an hour. You said some diarrhea, too?
Yeah.
Has that been going on for about an hour as well?
Yeah.
Okay. Turns out he has colitis, which is a inflammation of the GI tract. Very, very painful. He looked very uncomfortable. I believed him when he said it's 10 out of 10 pain.
What medical problems do you have besides the colitis?
HIV.
Okay.
High blood pressure.
Okay, you take all your HIV meds?
Yeah.
All right.
You do have high blood pressure. 172 over 98.
Yeah, this is what it did last time.
He's got a lot going on with this HIV. He's blind. He said his HIV caused him to lose his eyesight, like one of the complications of the disease.
Can you come with us, sir?
Yeah. All right.
Thankfully for him, he's got a great partner. Very supportive, and they definitely take care of each other, it seems.
He had his gallbladder removed a couple months ago, and that's the drawback from having his gallbladder removed, is you get colitis from that. Hate semen pain.
Oh, man.
When you see someone that's that in pain, it's obvious. I mean, you feel bad. You know, you want to be able to do something. Unfortunately, with his condition, there's nothing we can do. So we try to comfort him.
Thank you.
Now, make him as comfortable as we can. And just really get him over to the hospital as quickly as we can.
Hopefully we can get this under control quick.
We're coming up on 2 year anniversary. He's adorable. Very smart. Very smart, very intelligent.
He see me one afternoon, he just couldn't take his eyes off me.
I couldn't get enough of him. You know, it's like that ever since.
These two guys who are in a loving relationship for so many years and living a great life, even with HIV, it doesn't seem to stop them at all.
We do a lot of outreach for HIV and AIDS. HIV is not a death sentence anymore. People are living longer and happy and healthier lives now because of the new medications that they have out.
Couple bumps coming out, sir.
One more, that's it, I promise.
Okay.
I'm trying to avoid them.
So with that, I mean, life is good. Life is good.
Watch your head and watch your step.
As I said, you back here again. And then we'll just give me a penthouse suite upstairs.
Come here 10 times, your 11th one's free.
Next on Boston EMS.
What does the pain feel like? Constant or is it coming and going?
It's coming and going.
Take a couple deep breaths. Just breathe through it.
We are on our way for an 8-year-old male with abdominal pain and vomiting. It can be very difficult sometimes working with little kids. They don't feel good and they just want to be with their parents and any strangers might scare them. And we're going to the third floor.
It's like going into a haunted house here. It's so dark.
All right, what's going on with your boy?
He told me he got a stomach pain.
Okay.
And you know, in my country, I think it was gas. I make some tea for him.
Yeah.
And then he said he's still not feel good.
Okay.
And then he went to the bathroom and he still up.
Okay.
How long have you been feeling like this? When did it first start?
After I was in the car.
Tonight? Yeah. Okay. Let me see your hand for a second.
You know, you can walk into somebody's home and have somebody's child that doesn't feel good, and the family will be scared.
Hi.
But the minute the little girl locked eyes on me, she was all mine, and that's okay, because the brothers see that, then they're going to be comfortable. How's your tummy? Not good? Okay. We'll go down to the hospital, see if we can get you feeling better. All right. Hurry up and get out of my way.
What does the pain feel like? Is it constant or is it coming and going? Okay. There's a lot of different reasons that they could have abdominal pain. Could have been like a neurovirus. Could be related to his appendix, which is a common illness. Just take a couple deep breaths, okay? Just breathe through it. I like doing calls with little kids. You get to take an intimidating process like going to the hospital and seeing the doctor and getting in the ambulance and just make it a little more fun for them. Did you hurt your finger? You were just showing me your finger. Let me see your finger. I'll put it right here on the finger. All good? Give me a high five. All right, buddy, let's see if we can find you something cool in the toy drawer. All right, what do you think? Do you like superheroes? You got Captain America. They're going to do a bunch of tests on him. They're going to try to figure out what's causing his pain. They might give him something for his nausea and, you know, go from there.
Oh, my goodness, that's awesome. I know. Come here, pretty girl. Yeah. You know who loves you, right?
Yeah.
Kids are great. I'm a big kid myself. And,
What's
your tummy?
Mommy.
All better.
Some people say you're just goofy, but I don't care. I like being goofy and I like making kids laugh.
Boo.
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 I'm going to an EMS investigation. 85-year-old gentleman said he needed help. That's all it says. Going to Mattapan. We here now. Yeah, I've been here before. Ah, Mr. Chubbs. Yeah, this dude owns his whole crib by himself, you see. Yeah, nobody else lives in there. Just him.
So what's going on?
My wife died 5 years ago. Yeah. I ain't done no good since.
You want to go talk to somebody at the hospital?
No. The only thing I suffer from is dizziness. But if I sit down...
Well, sit down. Let me check your blood pressure.
If I sit down, I don't have any problems.
We can get you some elder services, and they can get you a button, so if you fall, you can press it, and we'll send a bunch of people to help you.
Please, my brother.
Do you have high blood pressure?
I guess I do.
I think you do, too.
What?
It's really high.
Huh? Same thing last time your blood pressure was high.
240.
Oh, yeah. You know what? You should go to the hospital.
Well, they prescribe medication that makes me sick as a dog. And they tell you, well, you just got to bear it. But I said, how long do I have to bear it?
Mm-hmm. The alternative is a lot worse than just feeling sick.
No, the alternative is to be dead. That's the alternative.
I understand you.
He needs help. But if you refuse, there's nothing we can do, you know?
Well, that's when I was in the Air Force in 1950. I was a medic.
He's a proud man, you know, he's proud. He's a stubborn man, you know.
Hey, I remember you real well. God bless you.
Thank you, sir. How are you, man?
Terrible. I wish I was dead. That's how bad I was.
You need to settle down.
You take him to the primary care physician, probably the best thing for him.
He won't go. You know, I feel sad for him. He gets like this from time to time. I really don't know what to do. All I can do is just be there for him. I'm just suffering from old age. It's going to happen to you, all of you.
If you live
to be 85 years old, you're going to see a tremendous difference in your life.
Boy, I'm not going to argue with you, but if you don't...
You can call medical control, but
yeah.
I'm not wrestling him out.
No, 85 years old.
Well, I just appreciate you gentlemen coming by here. But I just born to sit here. I think...
If we fight him, I think it's going to make him sicker. He's going to fight. Why fight that man and make it worse for him? But eventually, his son-in-law says his daughter can talk to him and get him to go to hospital. So that's what he needs.
Hey, babe.
What's up?
Yeah, that'd be great. We got a little bit of downtime because we're not on a call. Yeah. All right, I'll see you in a bit. Bye. Lisa's gonna swing by. She just told me that she's in the area. She's gonna pick up a coffee and come by.
Okay.
You'll actually get the chance to meet Lisa. Christ, we've been working together for a year now.
I know.
At least you get to meet her now.
Her for me.
Yeah, maybe a little bit. Yeah. Terry and I have been working together for about a year now.
All right, I'm gonna go in.
And we've actually been planning to have a sit-down dinner where I would meet Terry's spouse and Terry would meet Lisa. So we've been trying to arrange that for a little while, but that's the tough thing about obviously working in the ambulance is, you know, you gotta take advantage of whatever little bit of downtime you have. Hey, babe.
How's it going?
Good. Thank you.
Coffee.
Thank you very much. I needed this.
No problem.
Well, let's go inside. I'll introduce you to Terry.
I've heard so much about him. I've been dying to meet him.
So, first and foremost, Lisa, this is Terry. Terry, this is Lisa.
How are you?
Good, how
oh my
are
God,
you?
I've heard so much about
Same.
You. It's awesome to see you finally.
Nice finally you.
It's been so much fun planning the wedding.
Oh, yes, it is.
I don't know how you take care of this one, but it's a lot of work.
I know.
A10.
A10 indoor, system seizure 359 Lithgow Street.
Yeah.
Lithgow.
All right, so that's kind of what we expected. That's how the night goes. Well, thank you very much for coming by. It was nice to see you, and thank you for the coffee.
Hello.
Appreciate it.
No kidding for me? Please, no, it was really nice.
It was.
We are going to have dinner, mm-hmm. and it's supposed to be great.
Yeah, I can tell, yeah.
Jeez.
Oh my God, this is adorable.
Up close and personal on the streets of Boston.
I ended up dying, like, you're not gonna die.
Is there a major artery or anything?
We don't know. You were shot in the groin, but we don't know where the bullet is.
I think it's right there, way up in your thigh.
Look at her wrist, her wrist broke.
Hold on, we're going down Francis Street.
They need to fix these damn streets.
Ambulance 13, Boston. A minute from now, I could be in the middle of complete chaos.
Get out of here, dude.
Hey, the area's not safe.
Report of someone in the water.
Yeah. So we got two patients, one's critical.
Oh my God.
Get sliced in his belly.
Speed is a factor.
You gotta move, lady. You gotta move.
We're actually urban warriors. It's just, it's Boston. That's what we do.
Boston 86. Report of a person shot. Dorchester Ave, Dexter Street in South Boston.
Police are calling that they have a guy shot. C8 Ave to Dodd Ave and Dexter. You know, you think about scene safety, but this sounds like there's plenty of police there. And mostly with shootings, you know, you think about blood loss. Gentleman, he was laid out on the sidewalk with the police officer there. He was shot way up in his upper thigh. Which side are you shot?
I fall right here. Oh.
It looked to me like the gunshot happened at relatively close range because there was actually a powder burn around the wound.
You're not losing a lot of blood right now. We're going to put you right in the ambulance.
Any patient that says they're gonna die because they might know something you don't. He's shot in his upper thigh. It's like up underneath his scrotum, really. Come on, you gotta let the bag go. Let the bag go. On our end, the guy's awake, he's alert, he's not sweaty, he's not pale, but he has the potential to deteriorate. Because you can lose a large amount of blood into your thigh. So we don't want to waste any time.
Where it is? Here, there's no legs, it works.
It's definitely in your leg.
Is it a major artery or anything?
We don't know.
It's way up in your thigh. I think it's right there.
Injury, possible MVA, O'Connor, Columbia Road, at 31810.
We're going to a busy rotary for a female who's lying in the rotary. Question of airbags deployed in the vehicle, facial injuries. It's not very specific. It definitely has potential to be bad.
Let's get you in the ambulance, okay? Does anything hurt?
My eyes.
Your eyes?
Yeah.
Did the airbag go off in your face?
I just see sparks.
Come over here and have a seat.
Yeah, it looks like it caught fire.
I just don't know if she burned her eyeballs.
Sounds like she's complaining of facial injury, her eyes, the airbag on the driver's side caught fire, and you can actually see the plastic is singed. There's not a lot of damage to the front end of the car. The wheels, axles are intact. There's no bumper damage, so that's good. Are you okay, sir? You were the passenger of this vehicle?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you need to get checked out? Is anything hurt right now?
No, I'm fine, man.
You sure?
I'm just freezing.
If you look at the steering wheel, right where the airbag deploys from, the airbag came out and it does look like it caught fire. Yeah, it's all burnt, the plastic's all melted, so.
She got some very severe burns to her sclera, which is the white portion of your eyes. You really couldn't even see the pupil of her eyes because it was so blistered over. It's just a cold cloth that I'm going to put on your eyes. So that
like, applied some sterile dressings with some sterile saline water to help with the pain.
I try not to.
Can I do that?
Yeah.
Thank you.
There you go. You put the pressure on it, okay?
It's kind of helping.
Is it good?
Yeah.
All right. So I'm going to sit you back up a little bit.
Is that more comfortable?
Yeah.
All right. There we go.
Can you see it all?
Well, when I got out of the car, I opened my eyes and everything was just blurry, but the skin on my eyelids do feel burned.
Doing all right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I thought she was blind instantly. That was like my main concern. Yeah, definitely. Because I seen everything else on it was all right, and I just didn't want her to lose her eyesight, you know? It's a very serious thing.
All right, darling, we're here. Okay?
I'm going to pull you out of the ambulance, okay?
Yep.
She's 20 years old. It's a serious injury.
Good.
We hope there won't be any permanent damage to her sight. Definitely in your leg.
Was it in a major artery or anything?
We don't know. You were shot in the groin, but we don't know where the bullet is.
This was a call for a person shot. He was shot in the right side of his groin at close range.
Were you trying to tuck a gun in your pants? You sure?
Was it?
All right.
There was no hole in his outermost layer of clothing, so if somebody else shot him...
No exit wound.
He would have had to have had a hole in his pants, which there wasn't.
It's all police calling.
How you doing? Did you shoot yourself?
I was sitting on the stairs and someone came out and pointed it.
Really?
Yeah.
All right, take care of you. Sure you didn't do this?
I didn't do it.
All right. Gonna go to the hospital right now. I was a little forward with my questioning. I didn't really beat around the bush. Many times in our experience that we have someone that shot right there in that spot, it's sometimes self-inflicted. By accident.
I shot in the chest before. I'm much more worried about this. Yeah. 1994.
This third movie.
Oh, my God. I'm a 276.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Relax. Relax.
It's like if I survive, it's like...
You'll survive it. Don't worry about it.
I can't change my life. This is crazy.
Yep.
I just had a baby. Like, I can't do this.
You're going to see a baby. How old is your baby? All right, he's a real baby. There you go. He was very lucky to have had a gunshot wound right there and miss any big vessels. He could have lost his life. There's going to be a couple of bumps coming out, all right? Don't figure it out. We did jump the gun about maybe how we thought it happened. He denied it. That's okay. We're not judging him. He's, you know, he's a patient first. So it's our job to let him know that he's going to be home to his family and his 9-month-old. I think he's going to be fine.
Some biker slipped on ice and can't move. Hurt his hip. No head strike, no LOC.
I ain't doing it for my health.
Is he inside the arboretum? We can't get in the arboretum. The gate's closed. We used to have keys to every gate in the city and every truck. I don't know what happened. I don't know if somebody did something to get him taken. Remember that, Bo?
They gone now.
Yeah.
We don't have them.
Hey, Bo.
Yo.
You want to get out and check him?
Yeah, I slipped on the ice on my bike. I landed right on my hip. I can't move my leg.
Okay. Let me know what it hurts. Right over here, brother?
No, more on top. Like right
here?
Yeah, like right there. Oh, okay. Yep.
All right. So we're going to get the stretcher and get you out of here and get you in the warm. Hey, kids, left side of hip pain. Other than that, no C-spine tenderness or nothing like that. Make sure it's not a fractured pelvis or anything like that. So one of the major concerns, if you do have a pelvic fracture, you can actually bleed a good volume of your blood supply, like almost like 2/3 of your blood supply, into the pelvic area. It's almost like a cavity like that.
No matter what we do right now, it's going to hurt. So we're going to just lift you up and get you out of the cold, okay?
Jesus.
Got to get you on the side. Ready?
Okay, let's go. Right. Let's do it. Do it. Do it. Come on.
Ready?
Go.
Two.
Go. Oh. Oh, thank you. Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. Oh, we got it.
We got it. Get you inside. Oh. So you warmed up.
You know, this is the time of the year when you need to put the bikes up. Black ice, that type of stuff. Personally, in my opinion, put up the bike, take the T, carpool, whatever, so.
I work at an elementary school.
In Brookline. In Coolidge Corner.
You want to bike all the way out to Coolidge Corner, huh?
Yeah.
Impressive.
It's not too bad when you don't slip and bust your hip.
He's pretty much stable other than the pain there. But I did feel some swelling there, like maybe more muscular than anything else. But we'll see, you know. But I'm comfortable that he's a stable patient under the circumstances. One of the big things is some pain management, man, right?
Bring it on. That's what I
need. I know that's good. I think the guy's going to actually fare off fine. All in all, the life saves, you know. And on to the next, right?
Next on Boston EMS.
A lot of smoke. This fire is going really good.
Oh, I'm here when it first started.
Okay.
There were some animals.
Been an EMT for the state for between 6 and 7 years now. I got into being an EMT because I like to help people. It's, you know, fun being out here, meeting different people every day.
We got a little zoo here going.
It's fun. I've always liked anatomy, physiology, learning about medicine. I'm 25 years old, and I just proposed to my girlfriend, and now I'm saving for the wedding, so I'm working a little bit of overtime. Some people might think that 25 is an early age to get married. I mean, I had my fun, and I met somebody I really love, so it's the perfect time. I mean, I have a great job.
We're going to help you up, okay? We don't want to keep you here on the cold sidewalk.
A beautiful fiance, and hopefully we'll be starting the next chapter of our life soon, getting a house, having a couple kids.
Oh, I'm hitting a wall.
So the timing's great for me. Everything's working out. So we just got a call. A mother is calling for her 9-year-old son who has a hand laceration, and it says it's from glass. I'm sure the 9-year-old's going to be pretty upset. This is probably a pretty big emergency to him. So.
Hop right in there. It's cold out.
Come right over here for me.
So when we got on scene, we found mom outside with her two boys. So what happened?
Cut the glass.
Fell on a piece of glass? Okay. Okay, we're just going to clean it up a little bit, okay? You're being very brave. I know this is probably pretty painful, okay? So we got a little laceration here on the side of the thumb. So it wouldn't be a bad idea to get it checked out.
But it's not going to hurt.
Because,
listen, ready? Listen, they got this really cool glue that they can use too.
Yeah.
You don't have to put no
just like glue that you would use like doing any arts and crafts, they can do the same. Kids are really afraid of stitches. And they think that it's going to be this big, painful procedure. So he was just kind of scared, but we were able to comfort him and tell him that there are some other options.
It's hard being a kid.
I know, yeah. Being an adult's no fun, huh?
All right. Well, let's go get it fixed.
You got school in the morning?
I bet you they give you the day off from school to let your hand heal up a little bit.
You got a few boys, so I'm sure you...
Five sons.
Yeah. Wow.
So this is a basic ordinary day for me.
7 kids. She's got 5 boys. I only have 1 sibling personally, and I know that was crazy enough, so I can't imagine growing up with 6, 7 other siblings.
See? We're here.
Did they get up?
No.
We're going to bring you in there.
Yay.
Boys will be boys, what can I say? I just have to take it by a grain of salt.
Let your hands fall.
Oh, yeah.
Mom wasn't fazed at all. Boys are going to be boys, and accidents are going to happen. And I think she was pretty comfortable with the fact that it's not going to be the last time.
Be careful. Please, no more accidents. I don't need it. Not today.
Yo. Can we bring you in, too? All right.
Only 8 years old, so imagine what they're going to be doing when they're 16, 17, you know?
Responding out to Brighton. It's a confirmed fire.
There's no reports of any injuries, but we always respond to fires. You know, once the firefighters start working, there's a big potential for a firefighter to get injured.
Attention, engine 50. Cover station 33.
All right. And obviously, if there's any, you know, civilian victims of the fire, we want to be there and be ready.
Well, it looks a lot of smoke. I mean, this fire is going really good.
Yeah, there's no patients yet, but we got still heavy fire through the roof.
Everybody's out. This house right here.
Everybody's out.
Right.
Everybody's out of all the
homes.
We're not here when it first started.
Okay.
There were some animals in there.
All right.
We came up here. We saw the smoke billowing out. Of course, at that point there, we put it on the radio, and then I went out, and we kind of went... evacuated some people. Anybody who was in there was out. We made sure of that.
Our dog got out with us, which is awesome. We noticed that our sparks were going by our bedroom window, so we looked outside and noticed that the top porch was on fire. First, we ran upstairs to see what was going on, and we asked them, you know, did you call the 911 yet? They said no, so I called 911 and...